Are you having paper loading issues with your Sawgrass SG500 or SG1000 printer? Hey everyone, it's Jared with Heat Press Nation, and I'll be guiding you through a few steps you can take to fix common causes of paper misfeeds on Sawgrass sublimation printers. If your Sawgrass SG500 or SG1000 is having issues with loading sublimation paper, this may have happened in a couple of different ways. Either the wrong paper size has been used for the print job, a sensor or roller error has occurred inside the printer, the back cover of the printer is slightly opened, or the paper itself is jamming on the printhead. If your job is set to print on a paper size that's larger or smaller than the paper that's actually loaded into your printer, it will eventually detect the size as incorrect and it'll display a paper misfeed error on the LCD screen. To clear the error, simply press the job reset button on your printer. Then before sending the print job to Sawgrass Print Manager, make sure to set the right paper size and print scale for your transfer first. You should also check inside your printer's tray to see that the paper has been loaded properly and that its guide tabs have been adjusted to the paper size. If your paper size setting is correct and your printer is still unable to print due to a misfeed error, a sensor or roller bar inside the printer might be dirty and need to be cleaned. Turn off your printer and unplug it, then open the top and back covers. So this right here is the belt that we're going to be cleaning. If you see any dust on there, you're definitely going to want to take your microfiber cloth with a little bit of rubbing alcohol and be mindful of the print lines right here. They're kind of delicate, you don't want to mess those up. So I'm just gonna reach under here and I'm gonna very gently just clean it with the cloth and with the rubbing alcohol. Now if you see it's a little wet, the rubbing alcohol should dry fast, but then you can just go with the dry side. And you just want to clean up any dust that might be right here on the belt. We're going to use these two gray rubber rollers to rotate the feed belt so we can clean the entire thing. To do that, apply a little pressure, easiest done with your thumb, and just roll it down. You don't want to force anything or apply too much pressure. Now if you go up, nothing's going to happen. It's just going to roll freely. You want to roll it down to where we get the new section. Same process, if you need to use a new section of the cloth, that's totally fine. We're gonna get a little rubbing alcohol on the cloth, very gently hold these print lines or these ink lines aside, and I'm gonna go ahead and just clean this up. Now this is not particularly dirty because it's a brand new printer. Yours might be a little bit more dusty than ours. So we got it with the wet rubbing alcohol side, and now with the dry side, we're just gonna dry that up, clean it up again, just very carefully. You don't want to apply too much pressure. You don't want to force anything. We're just cleaning it up. And so you're going to proceed with this. You're going to keep on feeding the belt. What you don't want to do is lift this silver roller bar. You don't want to lift that to get under there. Just feed the belt and repeat the process until the entire belt has been cleaned. In terms of sensor errors, it's worth noting that low quality sublimation papers might be an issue, as they tend to produce more dust than material supported by Sawgrass, like TexPrint, Jekyll DHS, and Caesar Easy Subly HTV. If your images are printing, but they're showing some skewing issues, you'll need to ensure that the back cover of your printer is completely closed. Look at the gray tabs holding the back cover to the printer and make sure that they're not detached. Then check either side to make sure that they're not sticking out. If they are, simply push the back cover in and double check that it's fully attached itself to the printer. You'll also want to make sure that the guide tabs on your paper or bypass tray are properly set for your paper size and that the paper is loaded correctly. Lastly, if your printer is still displaying a paper misfeed error, the paper might be sticking to a print head in some way or form. If jamming happens on rare occasion, there shouldn't really be any cause for alarm. You can try printing again by reloading your paper and performing the procedures we've shown here. So if your paper is constantly jamming, there might be a damaged part inside your printer. As a result, the paper misfeed error will continue to be displayed on your printer's LCD screen. Note any error code shown on the printer and visit support.sawgrassinc.com to get in touch with Sawgrass's tech support team and specify the error code to them. For any details or questions about Sawgrass printers and hardware, you can visit our website at heatpressnation.com. Or call my expert representative at 800-215-0894. Once again, I'm Jared with Heat Press Nation, and thanks for watching.